Hey guys, NoFR64 here, but my friends call me Chris, and I'm here with my fourth review, I believe. Yeah, my fourth review, and for this review, I'm going to be reviewing Monster Hunter Tri for the Wii, and I'll be doing Wii reviews for the rest of the year, at least one a week, either on Monday, Tuesday, or Friday, because those are like the times that I have the most free time on my hands during the week. Anyway, let's go ahead and start the review. Story for this game, there really isn't much story to be talked about. At the beginning of the game, this fishing village is hit by an earthquake, and you, being a new hunter, are, well, tasked with, hey, go save the village and whatnot, from the monster right here on the cover, the Legiacris. Anyway, after you go save the village from the Legiacris and whatnot, it is revealed that the Legiacris was not the cause of the earthquakes, because the earthquakes keep happening and you have to go defeat the Elder Dragon Cidaeus, and that's pretty much all for story. And moving on. Gameplay for this game is pretty simple, but the learning curve can be a little difficult. Gameplay for this game is, you are a hunter and you have to fight monsters, and you can use two control types, the Wiimote Nunchuck or the Wiimote and Classic Controller Pro. The Classic Controller Pro, for me personally and for a lot of people out there, works a lot better than using the Wiimote Nunchuck. The Wiimote Nunchuck controls, while they are pretty okay, but some have to be like altered so they can actually work, are usable, but I don't really per se, I wouldn't necessarily use them, and for me, they don't work at all, but anyway. So, the gameplay is pretty simple, and it works pretty well. The AI sometimes seems a little cheap. That's just one issue I'm going to bring up right now. The AI in this game seems pretty cheap sometimes. Sometimes when I'm playing online, or sometimes when I'm not playing online, they will spam, like, sometimes the monsters will spam the same attack over and over again to, like, and they'll do it enough times to where you can't even move and block or dodge this attack, so it's like, what? And it's really, really annoying with all that happening around you, that with the monster keep attacking you and all the smaller monsters attacking you as well, that, you can't really see what's going on right there, and the, like, well, not see what's going on, but sometimes it's just really, 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 really annoying, because the AI just sometimes spams attacks, and you can't move out the way, and you are just stuck, and you are screwed. Moving on from gameplay, oh, wait, one more thing about gameplay. I don't know if this goes into gameplay or something else. Anyway, there are six different weapon types, and they all work differently, and they all work well. None of them feel underpowered or overpowered. They all feel perfectly well for their types of weapons, and that's pretty much all I have left to say on gameplay. Okay, controls of this game. I think I already talked about gameplay and controls in the last part. So, okay, moving on to the presentation of this game. Presentation of this game is really good. The graphics are really, really good in this game for a Wii title. They have, like, the full motion videos in this game are just really, really good. They looked really pretty and just awesome looking. They're just awesome to look at. The in-game graphics are also pretty good, and with that being said, I would like to point out that I was thinking about something else. Because when you take an armor set and you zoom in on it, it looks really, really nice and detailed, and you can tell that they're all different, all the scales and stuff look different and everything. It's just really, really cool how Capcom put a lot of time and effort into putting all those details on the armor sets and everything. Weapons look different, and they all feel different as well. The music in this game is pretty awesome, and it suits, depending on the area you're in, it suits the kind of mood, well, not mood, but the type of feel the area would give off with the music and whatnot, so that's pretty cool. The music is done really well. Good job, Monster Hunter Tri composers and whatnot. Um, Also, the monster, like the way the monsters roar, they sound believable for the type of monster they are, except for maybe one or two monsters. They just sound weird and out of place with the roar they have, but still nothing that doesn't take away from this amazingly, like from this amazing game. Oh wait, I forgot to say something in the gameplay. Now I remember what I was going to say in the gameplay section. But that's pretty much all I'll say on presentation for right now. But going back to gameplay for a second, this game has an online mode where you and three other people can get together and you can hunt monsters. Whether they're people you know in real life and they have this game, and you know you get together on this game when you're not at when you're not at school or when you're not hanging out at each other's houses or something like that. And you know you can get on and hunt monsters, and you can and unlike a lot of other games, where you have to have like a complicated friend code. This is probably like my favorite of all Wii games when it comes to like getting friends on your seven, well, six and two bar, seventh page friend list. Because all you have to do to get someone on your friend list is to, step one, walk up to a character and, well, view the character, view that person's profile and whatever, that character's profile and everything like that, and then hit send message. Then all you have to do is go to make. And then when it says it'll have little, it'll have their ID and whatnot, and then it'll have friend request. Yeah. It'll be hit to no, and then all you do is hit it, switch it to yes, put a message in there for like, hey, how are you? You want to be friends? And boom, shakalaka, you're friends. And that's pretty simple. And well, I mean, they have to, reply and send you back. Yeah. So that's pretty much that. They can accept it or deny it. So still. If they accept it, then boom, shakalaka, your friends are denied, then you know you're just still hunting together, but you're not friends in the game. So that's all I'd say about the online. The online, well, besides the online, you can get more weapons and armor that you couldn't get offline. Also, there are like some quests you couldn't do offline. Certain monsters you can only hunt online, which is pretty cool that they did that. And there are event quests that happen every now and there's an event that happens every now and then where the sent where a sandstorm comes by and you're able to do some other stuff. There are like, I believe there are six different categories in quest online, 5, 1 through 6. Offline, there are still 1 through 5, but like the urgent quest, like when you beat the game, you have a couple more urgent quests added that you can just do whenever you feel like it. But those are basically the 6-star quests from online, and they. You know, if you want to see how you would do without a team on those quests, then you know, go test your mettle offline on those quests. Also, that's pretty much it I have to say on replay value. This game has a lot of replay value in it. Yes, it does. Because I've had 800 hours in here, but I still come back and play because I'm trying to get some more weapons and more armor and whatnot, so I can kill monsters faster, be more protected against certain monsters, and all that other stuff. So it's got a lot of replayability in there for people who like to do that kind of stuff. Or because the I met this one person who like, she was like, she got level 999, and on one of her profiles, or one of their profiles, I don't know if they were a girl or anyway, on one of their profiles they had all weapons, and then they had another one with all the guns, and this one and the one that I met them with that I had right now was all the armor. So anyway, yeah, there's a lot of replayability in this game. So if you haven't gone out and buy this and you're a fan of Monster Hunter series, but you know, it's you don't have a Wii, I mean, I'm not saying like go out and buy this if you have like deal out and buy a Wii for this game. It's like not one of those that you it's not necessarily a system seller, but I may be understating that game with not saying it's a system seller, but anyway, if you want this game for the Wii, or if you just haven't, or you've just been questioning it because you don't know whether or not it would be your taste, it may not be your taste, but you know, you can still give it a try. For those of you who are new to Monster Hunter series, I would definitely, this is probably a rent, but like for those dedicated hardcore fans, or just people who want it, who want another Monster Hunter experience that isn't on a PSP, then this is your game. Go out and buy it. They've actually lowered the price to like $20. I don't know if that's because the stock of it is just really high and it's not selling very well, or they're just trying to sell all the Wii games they can before the Wii U comes up, so they don't have like so much leftover Wii stock of games. I don't know. But I really want to see the next month on over here in the States, so I don't know whatever reason it is, but if it is for the they have so much stock left over, which I don't think that is. Yeah, I would really rec I really think you should go pick this up, and my verdict on this is a 5 out of 5. Well, not, yeah, well, no, 4 out of 5. There are some issues with this game, like certain lag. It's like sometimes offline lag, but like it's only slight amounts of offline lag, but also some lagging issues with Mushroom's attacks and the hit, and some of the times the hit detection is off. But those are the only minor issues that I have with this game, and the things that are like that are good about this game outweigh the bad. But so yeah, this is basically a perfect game in my eyes. Probably one of the only perfect scores I'll give for a Wii game besides Super Mario Galaxy, and when I get is Skyward Sword, unless Skyward Sword highly disappoints me, which I'm pretty sure Skyward Sword won't disappoint me. But anyway, yeah, I say go buy it if you want something to play on your Wii. That's a really good game. I know this game came out last year, and there aren't that many people on the servers anymore, but still, there are still a good amount of people on the server, so you won't just be sitting there by yourself bored. So anyway, yeah, go buy this game if you really want something to play on your Wii. That's really good. Again, I know this game came out last year, and that there aren't that many people on. Well, there are a lot of people still online, but I mean, there aren't as many people as there used to be on. There aren't, and I know there aren't a lot of people online still, but there are some people still online. Not as many people as there were last year or earlier this year. But still, there's a lot of people online, and I give this a 5 out of 5. It's go buy it, go do it now. You won't be disappointed. Also, if you want me to review a game, if you want, so what do you think about this review? If you liked it, leave a comment about it. And also, if you can tell me how I can improve my reviews, put that in the comments as well. If you want me to review a game, if you want me to review a game, I'll be doing Wii games for the rest of the year or until the Wii U comes out, whichever happens first. Well, until I run a either until the end of, for the rest of this year, and I'll start doing PS2 reviews next year, and I'll be doing Wii reviews until the Wii U comes out. But if you have a request for me to do a review, leave it in the comments. And that's pretty much it. See you guys later. This has been Nara564, signing off. Go buy it. Yeah, go do it.